As you might know, control electronic appliances via remote control is pretty good idea. Using a simple TV remote, I can easily turn on slash off my room lights, fan, bulb or whatever I want. I can control 4 different appliances with this single remote. It sounds quite complicated, right? Don't worry, I am going to show you every single steps and giving you every single information that can help you to rebuild this project. So, let's get started. I know you are already familiar with these types of remotes. These are called IR remotes. Basically, these types of remotes sends the data through an IR LED, aka infrared LED. Speaking about infrared, IR lights or infrared lights are everywhere around us who produces heat like sun, light bulbs, etc. That means there is a lot of IR noise all around us. To prevent this noise from interfering with our IR signal, we have to make our signal spatial. Generally, we use 38 kHz carrier frequency to transmit the data from the remote control to the IR receiver. Now it comes to receive the signal from the remote. To do that, I am using TSOP1738 IR receiver, which has integrated amplifier, bandpass filter, demodulator, etc. In this way, we can get rid of the carrier frequency and receive only the data signal, which is good enough for the microcontroller to process. Here I still miss something, the data formats. It defines which sequence of burst and pause represents 0 and 1. The most popular data formats are RC5, RC6, NEC, etc. But for this project, we don't have to worry about these data formats. Pre-made library for the Arduino microcontroller can help us a lot. Now connect the IR receiver to the Arduino Nano according to the schematic. This is the pin configuration of TSOP1738. The data pin of the IR receiver can go to the any digital pins of the Arduino. I have chosen digital pin 11. VCC pin of the receiver goes to the 5V rail of the Arduino and ground to the ground. Now the hardware part is ready. Next is the software part. Download the IR library, unzip it and copy it into this location. Now open the Arduino IDE, move into the example section and then I choose IR receive demo and upload it to the Arduino without any changes. After that, open the serial monitor and press those buttons which you want to assign from the remote. Now you can see the hexadecimal codes for those buttons. As I have said, this remote can control 4 different appliances simultaneously. So I have to assign 4 different buttons to turn on slash off the gadgets. For now, just for the testing purposes, I am using 4 different LEDs with 220 ohms current limiting resistor on pin 13, 12, 10, 9. After getting all the hexadecimal codes for the 4 buttons, I am going to edit the code a little bit. Now the software part is totally completed. But to drive the appliances, we need 4 different relays. But the problem is that Arduino's digital pin cannot provide that much power that a relay need to work properly. So to amplify the power, I am using 4 different NPN transistors. If you are getting confused right now, then don't worry. You can get every single details about this project on my website geekysommo.com. Link is in the video description. This is the time to connect all the components together in the proof board. First of all, I have determined all the locations for the parts like transistors, relay, regulator IC, etc. When I am happy with the results, then I have marked all the locations and enlarged the hole if it's necessary. And also, I have marked all the pins of the relay which goes to the 220 volt AC. Next step is the connections. I am not going into too much details about it. Check the video description if you want to know more. Now we are coming to the most dangerous part of this project, which is the AC wiring. If you are new in this field, in electronics field, then be careful with this high voltage AC line. It has the potential to kill you. Anyway, let's do the AC wiring to complete this project. I am using 0.5 square millimeter thick copper wire for all the AC wiring if you are interested. This red wire is the input line which goes to the relay. And these yellow wires are the output line which is coming from the relay. You can get every important information, close picture, circuit diagram, codes and also the pinout component list in my website geekysommo.com. Link is in the video description. Now I have set some male headers to connect the Arduino with female to female jumpers. And lastly, to connect the IR receiver, I have cut the one end of these three female jumpers and soldered it directly to the receiver. Most important thing is that do not forget to use shrinking tube. It prevents the unexpected short circuit. Here almost everything is completed, but hopefully you have noticed I have no power supply for the electronics. To do that, I am using a 1 amp power adapter and a DC jack. Now it's time to assemble everything. Connect the new circuit board and the IR receiver to the Arduino and everything is completed. Just for some indication purposes, I am using those LEDs with 220 ohms current limiting resistor. And as a final touch, I have used 7809 regulator IC for the Arduino and 680 ohms 1 watt resistor for those LEDs. After setting up my appliances with my newly created circuit, according to this diagram, the project is completed. Now I need to find a suitable case for it. But I am planning to set this circuit inside the switchboard of our bedroom, so I don't need anything like that. Okay, let's test this build. After connecting the power supply, as you can see, I can easily turn on slash off 4 different appliances like these LED bulbs. I can control these bulbs with different keys of a single remote. So, hope you guys enjoyed by watching this video. If you have any queries, then don't forget to comment down below. And if you want to rebuild this project, then every single information regarding this project is on my website geekysommo.com. If you like this project, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell for the future updates. Thank you so much.